to me, math is still a language. So it's a language of numbers. But there are actually different ways that you can answer one question. When you can see how it all connects together, that I think is fun.
There are kids, especially at the upper level, where the number isn't enough. We're teaching them, okay, you got that number, how did you get there? What does that number tell you?
I think the exciting thing as a teacher is to watch that process of students not only move forward, but also stop for a moment and see if they truly understand.
Tell me if you're ready.
Yeah.
Yes. Okay. First round.
We do a lot of board work, so we get to get out of our seats and make sure that we know the material so that we're not just like writing notes. We actually understand what's going on.
You want this area to equal half of the original area. Let's see if now you have it right.
I still would say the class atmosphere is really like cohesive. When like everyone's kind of happier and like joking around, it makes it easier to like ask a question. You don't feel like everyone's gonna turn around and stare at you and be like, oh my gosh, you're asking a question. It's like, oh, like you're asking a question, this might be able to help me too, you know, so please, like, go ahead.
Because we're looking at this, right?
A lot of these skills are interdisciplinary. I mean, you sit down for a history DBQ and you have, here are your documents, here's the argument you're trying to make. Just like you sit down with a word problem and say, well, here are the numbers I know, here are the things I don't know, how am I gonna get from the unknown to the known? And that's something that they're gonna deal with in all their classes. That's something they're gonna deal with outside of class.
I threw that up there.
Here's what we're trying to solve, and how are we going to use the ideas of physics and also calculus and draw it together to get the correct answer.
When you go into a test, you know that your teacher has taught you well, so you know that you're going to get it right, and then when you actually do get it right, it's satisfying.
When you can go and tackle a problem and go through the necessary steps and actually arrive at the answer, it is definitely a great feeling.
It's 0.056, right?
And I think that is a big part of what math is.